Children, let us continue the chapter, triangle. We have already learnt about the SAS congruence rule, ASA congruence rule and AAS congruence rule. Now let us discuss about the next congruence rule, that is about the SSS congruence rule, side, side, side congruence rule. To verify this, you do an activity. Construct two triangles with sides 4 cm, 3.5 cm and 4.5 cm. Cut them and place one triangle on the other triangle. What do you observe? Perform the activity and verify the result. Now, if you place one triangle on the other, consider here the two triangles are there. Triangle ABC and triangle PQR, and the sides of the triangle ABC are 4 cm. AB is 4 cm, BC is 4.5 cm, AC is 3.5 cm. In triangle PQR, PQ is 4 cm, QR is 4.5 cm and PR is 3.5 cm. If you place triangle PQR on triangle ABC or triangle ABC on triangle PQR, they overlap one another. They coincide with one another. Here you can observe that AB and PQ coincides with each other. The side BC and QR coincides with each other and the sides AC and PR coincides with each other. Here you can say that if the sides of one triangle are equals to the corresponding sides of the other triangle, then those two sides are congruent. This is nothing but SSS congruence rule. So what is the statement of the SSS congruence rule? If three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. SSS, that is three sides of one triangle, are equals to the corresponding three sides of another triangle. So let us write the SSS congruence rule, that is, if three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Now consider the triangle ABC and PQR. You write, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, AB equals PQ, right? AB equals PQ and BC equals QR. BC equals QR and AC equals PR. AC equals PR. So you can write, therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR according to SSS congruence rule. According to SSS congruence rule. This is about the statement and figure of the SSS congruence rule. Now about the RHS congruence rule. You do an activity. Construct two right angle triangle with hypotenuse equal to 5 cm and one side equal to 4 cm. Cut them out and place one triangle over the other with equal sides placed on each other. The two triangles cover each other completely and so they are congruent. What do you observe here? The two triangles cover each other completely. Therefore, you can say that the two right angle triangles are congruent. Here, the hypotenuse of one triangle is equals to the hypotenuse of the other triangle. and one side of one triangle is equals to the one side of the other triangle, and if you place one on the other, they coincides with each other, so they are congruent triangles. And you repeat this activity by constructing more number of triangles. In this figure, the two right angle triangles are triangle DEF and triangle LMN. The hypotenuse DF is equals to 5 cm and also the hypotenuse LN is equals to 5 cm. And one of the sides of the triangle DEF, DE is 4 cm and LM is also 4 cm. If you place one triangle on the other, they overlap, they coincides with one another. Here DE and LM coincides, DF and LN coincides, EF and NM coincides, DE and LM coincides, DF and LN coincides, EF and NM coincides. They are the corresponding parts here, and as they overlap, they are the congruent triangles. And here the congruence rule can be applied is RHS congruence rule, that is right angle hypotenuse side. What is that? Right angle hypotenuse side congruence rule. And you can state that, what is the statement of the RHS congruence rule? If in two right angle triangles, the hypotenuse and one side of one triangle are equal to the hypotenuse and one side of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. So let us write the statement. Then the statement of the RHS congruence rule is, if in two right angled triangles, the hypotenuse, and one side of one triangle, are equal to the hypotenuse and one side of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. This is the statement of the RHS congruence rule. Here, while taking, we have to consider only the right angled triangle, and hypotenuse of one triangle is equals to the hypotenuse of the other, and any one side of the one triangle is equals to the any one side of the other triangle. Then they are congruent to each other. Then let us take the triangle ABC and triangle PQR, in which angle B is right angle and also angle Q is right angle. Now you write, in right angle triangles, symbolically ABC and right triangle PQR and angle B equals angle Q need not be required here. You write directly the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse AC equals hypotenuse PR and the side AB equals side PQ. Therefore, you can write right angle triangle ABC is congruent to right angle triangle PQR. Right angle triangle ABC is congruent to right angle triangle PQR, which congruence rule? RHS congruence rule. RHS congruence rule, you got that. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Here, the congruence rule completes that you have studied SAS, ASA, AAS, SSS and RHS. And also, we solved many examples on the basis of the congruence rule SAS, ASA and AAS congruence rule. Now, in the next, let us solve the problems based on RHS congruence rule and SSS congruence rule.